Alright, part two of my playthrough. Making sure my shit's in sync here. Trying something out today, that's why it's only in 720p, if anybody notices.
Broadcasting on a very low frequency. If you can hear me, I'm not far.
Please help me.
I've locked myself in storage room C4. Please, if anyone can hear me, please help me.
Apologies here. I think the audio is slightly behind. I'm going to refresh something on my capture shit real quick. Okay, that sounds much better. To look at the stupid PDA. No, that's not it. All right, 038. Ready then?
Thank you.
Since the dawn of the space center, Union Aerospace has been at the forefront of not only developing new technology, but pushing those developments to even more depth. With an abundant production. That fuel to make the dream of deep space research a reality. The answer is a resounding yes. Under the direction of Dr. Malcolm Bell, key UAC scientist.
Marines, Bravo team reports they've located your position but are unable to move to your current location. Head through engineering and try to link up with them in Sector 3.
Don't shoot. I can help you. The lights are all out. I'll lead you through here if you can get me off this base. Electromagnetic pulses have knocked out the electrical systems in this area. Watch out. A big one could knock out our lights.
All right, well, that's annoying.
What was that?
All right, I think I could have figured this out. Kind of thinking he was gonna get killed.
Audio report regarding the disrespectful treatment of new research staff. September 14th, 2145. As you know, I have gone to considerable effort to recruit my staff researchers for Alpha Labs. Finding team members with the qualifications, let alone the willingness to come to Mars, has not been a trivial task. You know this already. But it is necessary that I emphasize why their complaints must be taken seriously. We won't be able to keep our people who recruit new researchers with the harassment. No, harassment is exactly the right word. I'm routinely getting reports of UAC security asking inappropriate questions and submitting my staff to unnecessary background checks. I must insist that we be allowed to keep our personal lives private and be left to complete our assignments without further delay. If there is some kind of security, I suggest that UAC security into their own staff. This is Andrew Chin.
What the hell was that? Okay, I actually have a notepad file with all the names of the levels. I'm going to bring that up so we can track my progress. All right, Doom 3 level list. All right, what level am I on? Okay, I think I'm on Alpha Labs Sector 3. Okay. Let me scroll down here. Alright, I got a shitload of levels left. Alright. For this video in particular, I'm going to try to make it to the monorail skybridge. Sounds like an interesting place to stop. See if I get there. Ooh. Thought I saw something up there.
Toxins present. Please execute cleanup procedure.
Alright, how the hell do I get in there? Poop.
Toxic gas levels decreased 50%.
This is really silly. Ah, you penis.
Gas is cleared. Waste disposal area now safe for entry.
Marine, we gotta pick up the pace. We got more men down. Bravo team is barely holding their own.
All right, 047.
This is Operations Coordinator Mark Lamia, dated November 1st, 2145. I'm filing this report because I am frustrated beyond belief by the level of incompetency I have to deal with here. I don't know where HR is getting the new employees, but the last 5 months they sent me were all a bunch of idiots. Any of their work done on time, I constantly have to keep an eye on them. They work slow, they don't follow any of the standard operating procedures, and they can't even remember basic things that I tell them. For example, I changed the cabinet door codes here to 123 because I thought that was easy enough to remember, but they still forgot. I don't understand why HR can't get me better people. I'm requesting full authority to hire and fire my own employees. It's the only way I can run my department smoothly. End of log.
Alright, I'm gonna see what's the other way first.
Thank you.
The fuck? Alright, that was cheap.
Marine, I was able to locate your position. Four cops assumed that they had been out bunkered and shut down. Massive service disruptions throughout the entire base. I don't know how long I'll be able to track you. Bravo team has just entered the end program. Pick up the pace. You aren't far behind.
Oh, I could have fucked him up. Oh well.
Thanks for getting me out of there. I got trapped in the chamber when the power went out. I don't know what's going on here. I don't understand why none of the systems are responding. I'm going to try to get an uplink into the main system. This is a secure terminal. I might be able to get a connection.
Alright, good thing I saved him. How the hell did he get in here?
I'm going to stay here. I can lock the door.
Alrighty then. I gotta get in the habit of checking my ammo count. What kind of footprints are those?
Marine, base schematics show all passages out of your area blocked. The only way through is by traversing the EF bomb.
mechanical subsystem with two possible rooms. Activating the system will get you a direct view of the station. Send the observer for a hostage sector of the lighting system. Make a choice. Good luck.
Alright, I didn't hear what the hell that guy said. Alright, cool, got a new weapon. Alright, time to check this stupid PT8 again.
This is the audio
damn
log
it.
Of plant manager Henry.
Keep
Nelson.
Playing those damn audio logs.
24th, 2145. I don't know how I should record this, so I'll just talk about what I know and what I need. I've had quite a few employees reporting to me that they've heard strange sounds, like voices talking, calling them, even when they were alone. At first, I didn't believe them. The guys down here like to kid around. They assured me they were serious. I ignored the stories at first, until one day, I heard something too. I was working on one of the lift-up service panels, and I distinctly heard the voice of someone saying, "Over here." I quickly turned to see who was there, but the passage was completely empty. I looked around, but I didn't see another soul. I even checked the work logs, and no one else was working near that area. I don't want to sound crazy here, but my guys and myself are a little spooked, and some of the guys were even talking about ghosts. So, to make everyone, including myself, feel a little more comfortable, I'd like to request that a security team make a thorough check of the EFR area. Thank you. Henry Nelson.
Alright. My capture shit seems to be freaking out. I'm gonna fix that. That's really annoying. Alright, that looked pretty cool. Alright, that's pretty easy.
Find that card and find it fast.
Warning. Coolant rod 2 offline. Main reactor operation gas leak stopped. Exceeding safe fire extinguished.
Alrighty then.
Service bridge now operational. Audio log of weapon analyst Teresa Chazar, dated November 3rd, 2145. I'm pleased to report that the preliminary tests on the ammo storage in the new Mach 3 plasma gun has far exceeded our expectations. We realized a full 50% gain in the storage capacity of ammo packs as a result of utilizing techniques engineered in the Alpha Lab molecular compactor. I believe with the ongoing compaction research, we will reach our goal of 3 times the plasma storage currently available in standard ammo packs. I would also like to mention that all of the employees here at the Enpro plant have been very helpful and quite eager to accommodate all of my requests. For security reasons, I've locked the plasma gun and the extra ammo in locker 063 with door code 972. End of lock. Reactor core temperature, 585 degrees Celsius. Warning, reactor core temperature beyond acceptable levels.
Marines, you gotta find that transmission card. If Swan gets his hands on it, I don't know what.
Do you see the card?
No, sir.
Okay, let's get to the communications facility. We can stop the transmission from there.
Whatever you say, Counselor.
Thank you.
farther I can go. Here, take the transmission card. We can't stay here. Isn't safe. We better move.
Go back, see if I can open that door.
Steve Hammer, service technician. Since Private Swenson wigged out, shot up that drink machine, then lit himself up with a plasma gun, we've all been a bit nervous. All of us in maintenance knew he was losing it. Finally, when that darn drink machine wouldn't accept his credits, he lost it. Started swearing up and down. You had to laugh when that machine lit up, but before any of us could react, he fed himself enough plasma to power an office building. There wasn't enough head to clean up. Just vapor. It's a bad thing to happen to anyone. Anyway, I know with all the psych problems we've had lately, we need the additional security, but when the guards start going nuts, I don't know, all this extra weapons and ammunition, I mean, do we really need so much firepower laying around? Well, a couple of us decided to lock up all of the unsecured plasma rounds we could find. The code is 734. I think we'll all sleep a bit better tonight knowing it's locked up.
Alrighty then. Holy ammo. What the fuck was that?
Oh.
Like the chainsaw. What the fuck was that thing?
Thank you.
Service lift called to station.
Well, this is annoying. Boop. All right, what the hell was that? Alright, save some time on that redo.
Service lift called to station.
Thank you.
Service lift called to station.
Oh, that's much easier. God damn it. All right, I'm gonna stop here and take a look at the video, see if I need to change anything for the next part. Look like my capture window is a little laggy towards the end there. If that came out in the final video, my apologies, but I've been having some issues lately. All right, that's the end of part two, I think. Might be part three. I think it's part two. All right.